thereof, the paths of light. Do you know the way of light? The way, the paths to the house. The paths to the house, the paths of light. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time ever, you have been shown the paths of light to the house thereof. Did John Lennon really use meaningless lyrics to confuse people who were reading too much into his songs? Or is it possible he was gifted with the insight of seeing the universe across the universe? Your inside is out and your outside is in. The higher you go, the deeper you fly. No longer spinning on the merry-go-round. No longer on the ball, but in the ball. Looking through a glass onion. Interesting lyric there. Let's imagine we are John for a moment here, and we're standing on a cast iron shore, looking up into the sun through a glass onion. Now, a cast iron skillet is both convex and concave, depending on which side you're talking about. However, if you're standing on a cast iron shore filled with water, it can only mean you're standing on the concave side. Now, John sees the sun as if the light was being splayed out as it hit a glass sphere enveloping the sun. That's why Eddington and Einstein foolishly thought gravitational lensing displaced stars. Having a series of reinforced laminated glass spheres. That's why we see the supernumerary rainbows. Increasing the refraction and the electromagnetism is bending the light to create the menorah effect as it wraps around and then converges out in front of the sun, creating an onion shape, looking through a glass onion. Also, at the top of the onion, it has the shape of a dovetail. Like a dovetail joint, there is a convergence area there that creates a dovetail. Interesting that the Holy Spirit symbol of the dove, a sure indicator that reveals direct sunlight is being pinched toward an area in front of the sun, is by seeing the red on the inner circles of both the 22nd and the 46th degree halos, indicating a negative index of refraction. Normally, the red will be on the outer ring of a rainbow projected through glass. Hence, when the sun is behind us, the 22nd degree halo flips from a negative to a positive index of refraction, while the secondary rainbow remains negative. This reversal is indicative of bending light through glass with its direction of curvature and its sign of refraction influenced by magnetism and phase conjugation. Now let's look at why Lady Madonna is trying to make ends meet. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the answer to the biggest mystery that helioseismologists face, and that is, where do the magnetic flux lines of the sun connect, if at all? Well, looky here, they got two onions and an interplanetary magnetic field. Huh! They say that through some process, as yet not fully understood, the sun's field must keep regenerating itself across 4.5 billion years of time. Well, now that we know that we're living inside the Earth and the sun is a magnet and the circuit completes itself as it wraps around and gets sucked back into the celestial sphere with the octahedron in the center, sucking in the light again, reconnecting it, regenerating it, and then shooting it up to the north apex where it once again emanates on the high arm of light and hits the back of the sun, which I know you'll just have to take my word for it, is dark flat, and there are a series of collimated light rays hitting the diameter. Circuit complete. Loop complete. Arc complete. Fixing a hole in the ocean. What does that mean? Well, since Lady Madonna is trying to make ends meet, she can't quite make them meet at the celestial sphere, so there's a little hole in the celestial ocean. And it is the hole that is indicative of the dark region that creates the lunar eclipse, not the shadow of the earth. This is how the phases of the moon work. This also creates an interesting beetle pattern of light. Libyan desert glass sacred scarab, anyone? The fool on the hill apparently resides there. Well, that's the part that fools you. The fool is not there. Even though John says he's living there still, that was intentional to confuse you. The fool is down here. The Joker. The fool. I'm the fool. What about bent back tulips? Seeing how the other half lives. What other half? What are you talking about, John? Oh, you mean heaven. Seeing how that lives. How the light from the sun hits the celestial sphere, especially when it's behind the sun, almost as if tulip petals are being bent backwards. It's all there, ladies and gentlemen. The mystery is solved. Now you know the paths of light to the house thereof, where the fool is not there. The fool is here. Who else is going to present to you the harmonious relationship between John Lennon and the Holy Writ than me? Magnetic reconnection, circuit complete. You know the paths of light to the fool's house thereof. However, the fool's not there. I'm your host, Lord Stephen Christ. Thank you for listening. And as Casey Kasem would say, keep your head in your ass and keep reaching for the stars. You're another failure, aren't you, scientist?
Voltage. Voltage! Up! Up, up!
Up, 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 up!
He's an idiot. Degree in woodwork, I ask you. You're getting nowhere, are you, scientist?
Well, it's the plug, you see.
You're another failure, aren't you, scientist?
Oh, yeah!
Watusi. The twist.
Oh yeah, thank you for reminding me, Ringo. There's a twist to it as well.
Eldorado.
Travel the world.